Hello everyone. Thank you very much for joining in on this webinar. My name is Sunil Menon. I lead the application services and digital practice at CMS IT Services. I joined CMS IT nearly 5 years ago after a long stint with Oracle, where I did solution engineering using multiple Oracle products. The practice that I lead at CMS IT is focused on providing services around applications. Our differentiating factor is our approach, and therefore we have been privileged to have some very rich conversations around applications and digitization with our customers. We have learned extensively by speaking to our more than 300 customers, and they have been our great teachers in this journey. Digital transformation is by no means a new word. From the time computers have been an inseparable part of our daily lives, organizations have been working on how they could make them work for their businesses. Our objective in this session is to see how digital and innovative approaches can be applied in the applications management space. Our objective is to promote approaches that move the needle on application management services. We look at continuous improvement, continuous efficiencies in bringing cost and value enhancements to our customers. Let me introduce Ravi and Sandeep to take the session ahead. Sandeep and Ravi are seasoned applications professionals with more than 3 decades of applications experience between them. They will tell you about the approaches that we have been championing with our customers across the country. While Sandeep and Ravi are speaking, all participants will be on mute. You can use the chat option to raise your questions, and we'll take up a few identified questions at the end of the session. With that, I hand over to Ravi and Sandeep to take you through the rest of the session.
Thanks, Sunil. Hello, everyone. I'm Ravi Francis. I'm working along with CMS IT Services for the last 5 years on the application services and digital practice. I joined CMS IT with a background of Oracle applications and around 10 years working with TCS and various G businesses in our various strategic roles. This presentation is the continuation of a series of webinars on digitization. In this session, we would like to establish what we at CMS IT Services have defined as our approach to transformation for an application management framework. The opening slide highlights our belief in keeping the way application management transformation journey focuses on quality, speed, efficiency, and cost. IT has come a long way. It is a representation given by Gartner. How does the digitization has evolved from IT craftsmanship with core skills, disengaged framework, program centric, to industrialization with effective solutions, customer engagements, process modeling, and service management. And then to business enablement, secure model, consumer oriented, and operation transformation in the context of digitization. Moving forward, as time passes, change is inevitable. And our focus area today, IT application management service, has undergone with key but remarkable changes. The modern day CIO is operating in an environment where most of his internal and external customers are demanding rather than responding to change. Let me start comparing how was the conventional application management services were driven and how those pillars are now modernized. When the journey for application management services started, the focus was how the services are delivered, based on which SLA was derived. But as demand started surfacing and with technological advancements, business started driving the new age SLA for business performance. If I talk about delivery model and support approach, West coming in and was more reactive. With times changing, there was an adoption of agile way of delivering and more proactive approach became popular. In terms of automation, buzz was there from the starting, but unlike old days, the AI and ML platform-based solution has taken over the need-based automation. So let's talk about the challenges. When you want a change, there is a big stack of challenges which it brings in, which you face day to day, but visible only you see with your bird's eye. I would like to showcase the key challenges in terms of technology, people management, and future strategy. If I talk about technology, it is the core backbone which has carefully designed landscape and associated complexity, which always pose a new challenge like how will you get rid of the substandard code and legacy technology? How you will ensure your data is secured with growing landscape, rigorous processes to be followed on each release or patching for multiple applications. Managing the workforce is again a big challenge with new applications coming in, skill upgradation development, or keeping up the motivation, and most importantly, managing the attrition by balancing the risk of AI coming into the play. Leaders always have to be futuristic ready, and which is a constant challenge which implies he has to create a value with new innovations, devise cost reduction mechanisms, failure management, security compliances, along with positive mindset in his governance layer. So now let's talk about the budget spending in IT. The scale of a digital business in a business where large volumes come in from the digital channels will often make it impossible not to digitize the process. And for digital transformation, every organization has an IT budget allocated. Every organization is driven by technology, and that is changing year on year, which demands a lot of spending. To be a progressive organization, IT budget spending plays a crucial role. And as in all, IT gets what? 20 to 30% of the budget? Their trend we see nowadays to maintain our current application-based enterprises are spending is around 60%. On new technologies, around 10%. And for repetitive support, almost 20%, which itself poses a challenge how we will transform. Now, let's see how a change management journey happens. As I said, change is constant and inevitable. But the journey has remarkable fruits, and outcome is a milestone which every organization is seeking. Change management journey involves everyone from top to bottom in the organization. Starting stepping stone is very crucial. That is to identify the areas of changes which will again involve a lot of exercise internally and externally, followed by the findings, the impacts and risks which will frame out the measures to be taken and which must be informed to each one in the system, which gets you a halfway through. The next halfway starts with an implementation of the changes and diligently followed with a discipline so that everyone participates in the process and become leaders, inspiring others to follow. Let's see the 5G plan now for, we can say, digital transformation goals. A program like digital transformation will have a profound and lasting effect on the way business transactions take place in the organization. For that reason, it makes sense for us to relook at our processes and ensure that they are in tune with the stated goal of going digital. An old notion that for maximum transactions, we need a manpower workforce. It's a new age, and digital workforce needs more empowerment with the help of intelligent agent deployments. Best practices are the magical spells in the current world, which gives you clarity and open your boundaries of operations with a focused knowledge. Mundane transactions are the need of the hour, which nobody can avoid. And if you have a process in place, it should be automated with cognitive abilities. Operations need to be handled in a more proactive and agile manner, which not only reduces the load on the support system, but gives you a breather for new innovations. With changing trends and adoption of new technology, an application upskilling of your existing workforce gives you a comfort and edge to enhance the business models as well. As I have covered the background now, challenges and goals. Now, I would like to invite Sandeep to cover the various processes, measures, and the aspects of CMS IT approach, which will enable you on this digital journey.
Thanks, Ravi. Hello, everyone. I am Sandeep Satale. I am working along with the CMS IT services for last 4 years on the application services and digital practice. I joined CMS IT with a background of solutioning and application development in BFSI manufacturing domain. Now let's talk about the cost reduction first. What should be the areas customer must focus to improve AMS performance, maintenance, and reducing the cost? Three same. That's little bit contradiction between these two groups. But it is also encouraging the IT leaders to know that their business leaders no longer really feel IT being cost centers only, but it become more strategic differentiator. Moving on, AMS processes in detail. Application support and maintenance are traditionally seen cost line items, not a lever to improve the business performance. As I discussed in previous slide, the perception is changing and reduced cost is not main priority. In future, user experience and agility would be the important guiding principle. The application services, which are mainly divided into four groups. The first group is application support, which mainly covers the L1, L2 support, which is delivered in response to the ticket raised in the ITSM tool. This does not involve any code change in response to the tickets. The second group is application maintenance services, sometimes covers code changes due to the defect or enhancement, as well as preventive maintenance activities or performance improvement activities, which are referred as L3 support. The third group is application operations, which covers proactive as well as routine maintenance activities and operational activities related to applications. It also involves server or platform level administration activities. The last group, service management, is default or applicable at any scope of engagement. This is mainly covered to implement industry best practices and processes, such as ITIL, CMMI, ISO, and others. Let's talk about the application modernization. The digital world has offered large businesses a chance to operate in a more dynamic environment, but they are often held back by legacy IT systems. For businesses to thrive today, it's imperative for them to drive change with application modernization. This results system. Some of the key challenges with the legacy systems are scalability challenges, losing competitive edge, increased total cost of ownership, loss of productivity for customers. But how exactly do enterprise manages this initiative without risking failure? Here are 5 keys to achieve this. The first one, it is essential that organization, prior to setting out on any app modernization initiative, take out the time and critically analyze the application they want to refactor. The second one, organization should also factor in the risks of their proposed legacy data migration initiative to determine the contingency measures that must be prepared for in advance. The main objective of modernizing your app is to align app functions with that of your corporate strategy and business workflows. Therefore, it is crucial that you first take your business requirement into account. The fourth one, it is critical that you identify its flaws and defects as quickly as possible. Make sure to follow numerous testing approaches and system-wide checks to get a thorough analysis of application performance and its impact on business processes and workflows. The IT governance mechanism will enable you to emphasize on core IT and business activities while keeping up to date with the status of project and application. Coming on to automation assessment. These are the key factors to assess the suitability of automation. The first one is required human interaction. Processes which requires engaging high cost resources whose time could be spent on higher value activities. The second is complex processes. Identified time consuming, difficult or confusing to navigate current processes. The third is easy to consume and control. Workflow, tasks or information exchanges are suited to the back and forth, natural to natural conversation. Mundane procedures. Professional frequently and repeatedly perform a task or exchange the same information. Now, moving to automation. User experience. Custom applications are unique and issues are different customer to customer environment. COTS and SaaS, although they are standard across the customer, but integration and customization are so unique, which results into different types of issues, and hence ASM automation is challenged, but scope of automation is expanding as the tools and processes are maturing. Automation can be start with application monitoring, high frequency incidents, and service requests such as password reset, application access request. Existing knowledge database can be used to identify the possible candidates for automation. Moving to automation benefits. Automation brings several benefits into nearly any type of organization, from an enterprise level firm to a small 10-person firm. These are some core benefits of automation. Digital innovation. In companies required reviewing all current processes to make the necessary changes to achieve their digital and corporate objective. Process digitization. Pass a process to digital format that could reproduce the process as it is, or it could improve what it already being done to include some optimization of the process. Machine learning. Over the past few years, there has been an expanding conversation around machine learning and what it means for the world. But let's think about what it means specifically for business. Given how persistent machine learning is becoming, with use cases spanning data security, financial trading, healthcare, and more, organizations should consider implementing this science wherever they can as a major competitive differentiator. Organizations that can leverage machine learning and intelligent analysis for continuous improvement. Automation helps to achieve increased efficiency, reduces the dependence on tribal knowledge. Value creation automation is currently being implemented in a wide range of industries. Without a definite value, no business entity can create an edge. And without an edge, no business entity can survive the tough market. The automation results are data-driven and measurable outcome. Moving to CMSIT approach. Approach for any transformation is the first big step. With CMSIT approach, we begin with detailed application portfolio assessment to assess the current state and design the proposed future state. Application portfolio assessment is a very exhaustive exercise, and it produces current state of assessment and recommendation report. It covers business case, which comprise areas of improvement and automation implementation possibilities. Detailed application assessment, which includes application technology stack, line of business mapping, understanding the business criticality of applications. The current and future support model recommendation report includes detailed support coverage of scope, SLA, ticket workflow, and shift management with a key process indicator for the health check. Every transition is unique and requires special consideration for multiple factors. The key element of the transition strategy for a successful and smooth process is systematic step-by-step approach. Also identify the possible risks and contingencies that may occur during the transition process and their mitigation plan. We ensure that the new processes resulting from a change will be adopted by people who were affected in a seamless fashion. The digital journey not only enhances the user and business experience, but showers a lot of saving directly or indirectly. By having so many good practices, processes and tools results into increase in productivity, ultimately generates more workforce availability for new initiatives. Digital intelligent agent deployed will do more predictive analysis and fixes with the help of self-learning capability and drive the unburdening of the load due to the repetitive tasks from the support workforce is a clear saving. Return of investment by saving the manual effort cost, investment in strategic application development for new businesses and IT initiatives, which can lead more businesses and robust confidence in the organization. Again, with the digital virtual bots can give an extended and consistent experience to the customer or internal users. It is an art of science which enables you not only interact, but also gives you a human touch, which is preferred way of customer experience. There are so many business processes and they are in conjunction with each other to give seamless functionality. But a simple breaks or delay cause a lot of operational cost. By the help of best practices, new digital experience initiatives, automation, and virtual workforce will increase the efficiency, which can decrease your operational cost. This was the second session covering the digital process management transformation in digital enterprise. We'll come back to you with detailed session on intelligent automation in digital enterprise and managing the digital experience in digital transformation journey. I'll request you to reach out to us and let us know if you would like to know anything specific on these areas that can be addressed in the session that follow. Also, please let us know if you wish to have any other session on digital transformation other than the ones I mentioned. Thanks again for participating. Good luck with going digital.